session, of course. And thank you so much for being with me this evening. So as I gave you the result of your practice, so I guarantee that you've read the answers, you've checked them all. Berarti bagaimana Bapak Ibu pendapatnya, your result, are you satisfied with it or gimana? Ayo kita sharing dulu nih, gimana? Padahal itu soalnya saya pilih yang jernih banget soundnya, and then masih level intermediate. Nah, nanti mungkin ujiannya saya pakai yang level di atasnya gitu. Gimana, Bapak Ibu, pengalamannya? Come on, share with me. Oh, masih dengar suara saya, Bapak Ibu?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Miss Fatmaina, maybe you can share with us about your experience doing the test. Gimana?
About the
material. Intinya agak susah or easy, gimana?
Intinya mungkin belum, maybe I'm not friendly, but so I just can write reading, but not friend. It's I must ini belajar bahasa Inggris ya, sure ya.
Yes, of course. I'm very apa namanya glad if you want to try to speak in English, because I'm not excellent in English. I'm trying to.
Yes.
Okay. I think so.
Jadi sebenarnya sangat mungkin bagi saya sangat lancar berbahasa Inggrisnya itu dari sudut pandang saya di pendengaran itu mungkin saya belum bisa nangkap secara utuh. Mungkin karena belum memahami semua grammar dan masih sangat cepat sekali bagi saya seperti kilat.
Yes. Okay. Yes, so that's itu. Your experience. Okay. I'm yes. very happy with your sharing. And how about the others? Maybe one from the men. Ada yang mau sharing? What's your opinion about the practice? Easy or hard? Or medium, gimana? Okay, sekarang maybe. Bapak Ibu, maybe how about you, maybe. Mr.
Maybe Sir. No, maybe hard lah.
Okay, so kalau kita bilang kalau makanan tuh medium size lah ya, artinya sedang ya.
Yes.
All medium right, hard. Thank you, share for sharing with us. Yeah. Last week we studied about how to do the test in short dialogue. So today we are going to again karena mungkin saya sudah jelaskan ketika when I checked just now the material, I remember that I have explained them all gitu ya, tapi saya akan jelaskan lagi untuk bagian B-nya, and then kita hari ini langsung praktek ya, baru kita bahas soalnya. Satu soal dulu baru kita bahas. Okay, so Bapak Ibu, I will share my screen as usual. So let me know if you have seen my PowerPoint. Can you see it now? Bapak Ibu sudah lihat?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
Thank you for respond. Yeah. So in listening B, we have a long dialogue, means longer than the part A. Yeah. Lebih panjang percakapannya, and then tapi but the questions will be shorter. I mean, kalau di part A it consists of 30 questions, but in part B we usually find only 8 until 12 questions. Tapi meskipun 8 sampai 12 soal saja, tapi kendalanya, the problem is we hardly understand the talk because it's longer, gitu ya. Usually we still remember the first statement or the first talk, but the other, the rest, ya, sisanya itu mungkin kita lupa, gitu ya. In the first sentence that the talk, we listen to the talk and the first sentence in she or he talks about, kita masih ingat yang mereka katakan pertama, but in line 2, line 3, and the last, gitu, kita biasanya sudah terkecoh, distracted. So, we have strategies here. Yang pertama, as I told you, saya sudah bilang minggu lalu, karena di lembar jawaban kita ini langsung disediakan pilihan jawaban. Nah, we have 12 seconds, kita masih mempunyai 12 detik untuk memperhatikan jenis pilihan jawabannya, ABCD-nya. Ya, kalau di situ ABCD-nya itu tentang waktu atau jam, nanti pasti kita bisa memprediksi, we can predict what kind of question is that. Pasti pertanyaan nanti when, gitu ya. But if we find the choices is the places, kalau kita melihat pilihannya itu adalah nama tempat, so pertanyaannya nanti akan where. Berarti kita nanti akan fokus sambil kita nanti mendengarkan, while we are listening to the audio, ketika kita sedang mendengarkan itu, kita bisa langsung jawab nanti, ya. Kenapa saya bilang seperti itu? Karena saya sudah berkali-kali mengerjakan tes TOEFL atau IELTS dan itu terbukti, makanya dibuat strateginya seperti ini. Ya, it will be helpful for us if we read first the choices sebelum ya, before we listen to the audio. Ya, jadi yang pertama katanya preview the answers. Preview artinya kita lihat dulu jawabannya, ya, pilihan jawabannya, ya. And then biasanya pertanyaan pertama itu misalkan satu long dialogue atau satu percakapan itu langsung ada 4 pertanyaan nanti. Biasanya pertanyaan pertama pasti nanti jawabannya ada di percakapan yang awal. Listen carefully to the first line of the conversation. Ada the first line itu nanti kalau ditanyakan topiknya pasti yang di depan itu yang nanti topiknya. Ya. Okay, as you listen to the conversation, follow along with the answers in your textbook. Jadi sudah dua keuntungan bagi kita. The first, kita sudah cek pilihan jawabannya, and then sambil mendengarkan audionya atau bunyi speakernya, kita bisa sambil jawab. Jadi follow along sambil mengikuti pilihan jawabannya itu, gitu ya. And try to determine the correct answer. Jadi sebelum ada pertanyaan nanti, kita sudah bisa 50-50 lah, menduga nih. Oh, tadi kan yang diomongin mereka itu tentang misalkan biology. Oh, ini nanti what's the topic? Berarti what's the field of the study that they're talking about? Oh, ini berarti mereka tentang berbicara tentang mikroskoba tadi atau ini pasti biologi nih, nggak mungkin physics, nggak mungkin math gitu ya. Oke. Okay. You should guess even if you are not sure. Seperti yang saya bilang kemarin, meskipun kita gambling atau main judi lah istilahnya ya, hitung kancing, tapi hitung kancingnya itu sudah tidak lagi seperti kita beli kucing dalam karung gitu. Artinya kita sudah ada kosakata yang kita dengarkan, ya kan? Sudah membantu banget untuk guessingnya, gitu ya. And then the last, use any remaining time to look ahead at the answers to the questions that follow. Artinya, ketika kita sudah menjawab, ya, menjawab 4 pertanyaan itu, kita ini lagi tuh cek. Oh, saya benar checklist-nya ya, gitu ya. Jangan-jangan kita lupa lagi checklist-nya gitu. Jadi, ada dua hal yang memang harus kita perhatikan ya. Jadi, sebelum menyerahkan lembar jawaban, sebelum melakukan tes, kita baca instruksinya, dan setelah melakukan checklist, ya, kita cek lagi, karena masih ada waktu, gitu. Alright, so that's the general strategies. Nah, okay, sekarang kita langsung ke contoh, ya. Predict a question. Dari pilihan jawaban, kita sudah, we can predict what kind of question is that, gitu. Ya, yeah, as I told you just now, if we find ABCD are about time, so the question must be about when. Yeah, on Monday next week, tomorrow after class, pasti nanti pertanyaannya when. Oh, nanti kita fokus oh pas kita sudah baca pilihan jawabannya nanti baru kita mendengarkan audionya kan, ya, oh ini pasti ini nih, gitu ya. Meskipun nanti mungkin akan berubah karena mungkin yang kita prediksi pertanyaannya bukan itu pertanyaannya, tapi mungkin berubah next week atau menjadi tomorrow gitu ya. Karena di percakapan tadi ada membahas tentang next week, ada tomorrow gitu. Ya. Oke. Skill 8, pay attention to the topic. Seperti yang dia bilang tadi, first line itu awal percakapan itu pasti di situlah first line-nya. Contohnya si A ngomong yang di sini, what did you think about the history exam? Ya pasti di sini noun-nya yang diomongin mereka itu adalah tentang history exam, gitu ya. Oke, jadi ini tentang ujian sejarah. Dan di bawah-bawahnya itu juga ada kata exam lagi. That was the hardest exam I've ever seen. Ya. Oke. Jadi yang ditanya misalkan what was the topic of the talk? Oke, kalau ada pilihannya berarti that's about history exam, gitu ya. Oke. So, skill 9, ya, seperti yang kalau kita sudah mengikuti tadi percakapannya, ya, sudah kita dengarkan, sebenarnya ketika kita baca soalnya lagi, oh iya ya, jawaban pertama itu ada di yang diomongin mereka pertama, dan pertanyaan kedua itu ada di bagian selanjutnya. Oh, soal nomor 4 itu ada di tengah-tengah percakapan mereka. Oh, soal nomor 5 itu yang terakhir gitu. Jadi dia order, Bapak Ibu, ya. Oke. Okay. So, we find here an example of a talk, ya. Yeah. Bukan a talk, a long dialogue. Kita baca dulu ya. Can you help me? I'm lost. Sure. Where are you trying to go? I have a class in Stanfield Hall at 3. I thought I knew where I was going, but I guess I was wrong. Yeah. Yes, certainly are lost. You certainly are lost. Sanford Hall is on the other side of the university. I'm heading in that direction. Come on with me and I'll show you the way. Thanks. You're a life saver. Ya, jadi kalau kita lihat di sini nanti, nggak usah saya artikan dulu. Coba kita lihat dulu pilihan jawabannya, Bapak Ibu. Nah, pilihan jawabannya seperti ini. He's sick, he's lost, he's tired, he's broke. Berarti yang ditanyakan nanti tentang he, berarti si laki-lakinya. Berarti ada dua kemungkinan, berarti kita tahu bahwasanya ada dua di sini pembicaranya, namanya juga berbincang-bincang, berarti kalau ditanya he, berarti nanti kita fokusnya ketika kita mendengar audionya berarti ke laki-lakinya untuk menjawab nomor 1 gitu ya. Oke. Yang kedua, direct in front of them to the left quite nearby on the other side of campus. Berarti ini tentang arah ya. Ya, ada to, ada in front, ya, ada nearby on the other side berarti arah. Gitu ya. Kalau di atas ini ditanyakan what berarti ya. Karena ini statement, dia sakit. Atau kenapa, bisa saja kenapa, karena dia sakit, karena dia tersasar, karena dia capek, karena dia butuh duit gitu, bokeh ya di kita ya. Oke, Bapak Ibu begitu, jadi kalau ini kita lihat berarti yang ada di benak kita, kan audionya belum nih, seperti yang saya bilang kita punya 10-12 detik, kita sudah melihat pilihan jawaban nih, he's sick, he's lost, he's tired, he's broke. Ya, yeah. And then kita muncul misalkan audio yang tadi percakapannya. Nah, jadi soal nomor 1 ini Bapak Ibu sebenarnya sudah kita bisa jawab dari jawaban dari percakapan yang pertama. Can you help me? I'm lost. Gitu ya. Oke. Okay. Nah, tadi sebelum kita dengarkan audionya kan ada di sini tentang directly front of them, to the left, quite nearby, on the other side of campus. Nah, ketika kita mendengarkan audionya, kita langsung udah bisa jawab, oh ini, on the other side of the university. Gitu, Bapak Ibu ya. Okay. So, yeah. Nah, Bapak Ibu, saya kembali dulu nih ke layar utama. Saya mau tanya dulu, Bapak Ibu, kita langsung praktek bisa ya? Suasana di tempat Bapak itu aman kan? Bisa dengar langsung? Artinya bisa mendengarkan dengan nyaman, dengan tenang, dengan jernih?
Yes, sir.
Iya, karena yes, karena listening kan memang kita harus praktek mendengarkan. Jadi, make sure that the condition of your area where you are now, where you are listening when you are sitting is conducive and ya quiet lah ya. Oke, kalau begitu berarti kita akan saya akan share dulu file itunya ke Bapak Ibu. Nah, Bapak Ibu nanti sambil dengar audionya, saya share di grup aja ya Bapak Ibu, biar bisa nanti di-download langsung. Oke, saya share terlebih dahulu. Oke, Bapak Ibu, can you please check our WhatsApp group? I send you the Word document. Judulnya, nama filenya Long Dialogue B. Can you check it, please? Have you seen the file?
Yeah.
Okay. Now I need you to download first. Kalau sudah download berarti nanti saya akan play audionya. Tapi seperti tadi strateginya, berarti saya berikan dulu 12 detik untuk Bapak Ibu membaca dulu pilihan jawabannya. Oke. Bapak Ibu tolong dipastikan filenya sudah terdownload. Have you downloaded? Okay, I do hope the file is okay. Okay, I'm waiting for your response. Sudah bisa download semua?
I'm processor.
Yeah, Miss Anissa.
Not yet.
Not yet. Okay, masih ini ya? Masih. On the process, sudah bisa dibuka
connection.
Oh, I see. Maybe it's related to our internet connection. Kalau koneksinya bagus, biasanya cepat downloadnya. So let me check the presence. So we are here in this meeting. There are 12, including Miss Nina and Dai. Berarti semuanya hadir ya, 10 people. Thank you so much. There is Mr. Alfif, Mr. Andres, Miss Anissa, Mr. Anton Subianto, Anton Supriyadi, Mr. Edi Janto, Miss Fatmaina. It's very unique, your name. Mr. Gad Edison Sonbai. Mr. Marudu, Mr. Tombek Robert Tua. I'm so happy to see you today. You've been very active in this second session. Okay, let me check. Have you successfully downloaded?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Have you all? Ada yang belum?
Yes.
Let me know. Okay, now I'm counting in, saya hitung dari sekarang 12 detik, berarti nanti saya akan putar audionya ketika Bapak Ibu sudah melihat pilihan jawabannya. Kita langsung praktekkan ya, benar nggak sih? Gitu ya, oke. Okay.
Taipei.
Is an influence. It's SD actually K23 to 19.
Okay, now okay. Miss Anissa, can you unmute first? Sorry. Jangan yang lain nanti nggak mungkin ter ini kali tadi.
Okay, sorry.
No, this will be a problem. Okay, saya akan putarkan. I will play the audio. So this is the audio for the four question. Yang pertama ya.
In this part of the test, you will hear longer conversations. After each conversation, you will hear several questions. The conversation and the questions will not be repeated. After you hear a question, read the four possible answers in your test book and choose the best answer. Then, on your answer sheet, find the number of the question and fill in the space that corresponds to the letter of the answer that you have chosen. Here's an example. On the recording you hear,
questions 31 through 32. Listen to the conversation between two people.
Is Monica there, please?
I'm sorry, she isn't here right now. Can I give her a message?
Yes, this is George. Please ask her to call me at work.
Okay. Can you give me your phone number, please?
Sure. It's 555-2891. On the recording, you hear, where are the woman and the man talking? In your test book, you read, A. In the office. B. On the phone. C. At Monica's house. D. At school. Based on the conversation, the suitable answer for the question, where are the women and the man talking, is on the phone. Therefore, the best choice is B. On the recording, you hear, what is the meaning of the word call? In your test book, you read, A. Phone. B. Mention. C. Screen. D. Talk. Based on the man's statement, please ask her to call me at work. It can be known that he hopes Monica will phone him. Therefore, the correct choice is A, phone. Now, begin work on the questions.
Questions 31 through 34. Listen to the conversation between a professor and a student.
There is one more section I'd like to spend a few moments reviewing before we close our books for the day. Who here remembers the film we watched last month on hazardous waste?
You mean the one about computer and television monitors?
Yes, that's the one, Lisa. In the film, they discussed why some states are making it illegal to dump monitors into regular landfills. Can anyone remember the reason? Yes, Lisa?
It's because of the cathode ray tubes, also known as CRTs. Inside them. These tubes are high in lead content, and the lead can leak into the groundwater, right?
Excellent. It's nice to know that some of you were listening, even though it wasn't the most upbeat documentary. Now, does anyone remember the reason why manufacturers place lead in the CRTs of computer and TV monitors in the first place?
The tubes are infused with lead in order to shield the viewer from harmful X-rays. There is no known alternative at this time, but I think the film said that researchers are working on it.
Yes, that's true. And why wasn't this a problem 20 years ago? Why is it suddenly a major concern?
That's simple. It's because nearly every household in the U.S. has a television, and many have three or four. My family is guilty of this, I admit. And not only that, people are throwing out their TVs and computer monitors in order to keep up with the new technology, you know, like the flat-screen LCD monitors. With the digital age upon us, this is going to pose even more of a problem. I have to admit, I got a new plasma TV a few months ago, and there was nothing wrong with my old TV.
Well, I'm sure you're not the only one, Lisa. Now, since you're on a roll, Why can't these old monitors just be recycled?
Well, unlike paper and plastics, there just aren't any services that provide this type of recycling. According to the film, a lot of companies that recognize the threat are storing their unused equipment in warehouses until some better solutions become available.
Yes, and this brings us to our next film. Lisa, would you mind dimming the lights? This film is titled Landfill Solutions. It deals with a number of products that can be recycled through innovative means.
Question number 31. What is the topic of the discussion?
Yeah. Okay, Bapak Ibu, jawabannya untuk nomor satu gimana? Kalau seperti ini, dengar suara saya kan Bapak Ibu ketika... Oke, ya Pak Gad Edison ya, Pak Edi.
Yes.
Oke, Pak Edi, jawabannya apa?
D. Recycling Elsa. Film.
Kalau Pak recycling, kalau Gad, Pak Gad?
B. Landfill concern.
Oke, landfill concern. Kalau Pak Robi tadi, Pak Edi. Pilihnya yang recycling films. Nah, Bapak Ibu yang lain, apakah ada pilihan selain B dan Bravo dan Delta? Atau masih kosong? Oke, kalau disuruh guessing Bapak Ibu, yang mana jawabannya?
A, harmful television.
Alpha.
Alpha.
Ini Pak siapa ini? Sorry.
Afif.
Oh, Pak Afif. Oke. Okay. Ada yang lain? Pak Afif, Pak Edi, dan Pak Gad sudah memberikan respon. Yang lain? Masih belum terjawab kah? Oke. Okay. Nah, di awal-awal tadi Pak Afif benar ya, di awal-awal mereka ngomongin televisi-televisi yang nggak kepake, berarti itu artinya ada harmfulnya tadi ya, membahayakan. So, the answer is alpha, ya Bapak-Ibu, harmful television. Nah, baru di setelah ini nanti kita masuk, kenapa sih, karena apa? Nah, oke. Okay. Nah, untuk pertanyaan kedua,
number 32. What makes monitors hazardous to the environment?
Iya. Ditanya kenapa monitor TV itu memang katanya berbahaya untuk lingkungan. Bapak Ibu, monitor TV-nya yang harmful tadi gitu ya. Kenapa membahayakan untuk lingkungan sehingga enggak ada perusahaan yang mau recycle gitu. Gimana Bapak Ibu jawabannya? Saya tunjukkan. B, ada SRT, X-ray, cathode, ray tubes, landfill. Meskipun ini bukan bidang kita Bapak-Ibu, tapi di obrolan mereka tadi ada yang ditekankan si perempuan tadi. Kelewat ya? Atau ada yang masih ingat yang tadi si perempuan itu tekankan tadi di omongannya?
Delta, sorry, landfill.
Landfills, oke. Okay. Kalau ini Pak siapa ini? Sorry, saya back ke layar utama. Pak?
Afif, sorry.
Oh, Pak Afif. Kalau Pak Afif terjemahkan landfills itu apanya tuh, Pak? Kalau bagian-bagian TV, kalau diterjemahkan, emang landfills itu menurut Pak Afif apa? Landfills. Oke, berarti meskipun tidak bisa jawab, berarti yang tadi diingat Pak Afif landfills ya?
Limbahnya itu, sir.
Oke, limbahnya. Oke, kalau Pak Gad?
Landfill itu pemahaman saya sih itu tempat pembuangan sampah, tempat pembuangan air sampah.
Iya, pembuangan sampahnya ya. Oke. Tapi Pak Afif dengarnya tadi itu. Kalau Pak Gat jawabannya apa? Atau kira-kira kalau secara umum ngomongin TV, yang paling berbahaya itu apa sih secara umum kita pahami? Tabungnya kan ya? Oke.
Cupnya, saudara cupnya.
Iya, yang sebelum layar itu kan di belakangnya ada ini ya. Seperti kalau kita belajar fisika tuh ada ion negatif, ion positif gitu lah ya. Oke. Yang pemancar itunya ke layarnya gitu, itu yang berbahaya. Nah, itu disebutkan perempuan tadi apa, Bapak Ibu? Ada tube-nya ya. Berarti jawabannya adalah
si.
Oke, kita nanti mendengarkan lagi ya, biar kita pastikan. Jadi, yang diomongin si perempuan tadi cathode ray tubes gitu ya. Oke, kita ke pertanyaan selanjutnya. Oh, belum ke play ya, sorry.
Number 33. According to Lisa, why can't monitors be recycled?
Iya, menurut si Lisa tadi, si perempuan, kenapa katanya monitornya tidak bisa didaur ulang, Bapak Ibu? Why monitor can't be recycled?
Is there no company that provide the service?
Oke, siapa tadi yang jawab ini, Bapak? Oke, Pak Gan. Oke. Ya, kata si perempuan tadi ada yang si Lisa itu ngomong seperti itu. Oke, ini pilihan jawaban Pak Gan. Yang lain? Kenapa dibiarkan saja di rumah-rumah televisinya katanya atau dibuang di lapangan atau di tempat sampah? Oke, tadi ini jawabannya cathode ray tubes ini harmful television. Nah, yang ini iya. Nanti kita dengarkan lagi ya, Bapak Ibu. You're excellent, Pak Gat. Thank you so much. Kata si perempuannya tadi there aren't gitu. Tidak jelas memang not-nya, tapi kalau mereka aren't itu are not ya. There aren't artinya there are not ya, tidak ada perusahaan yang menyediakan layanan untuk itu di zaman itu. Okay. So Bapak Ibu, we go on to the last question for the first dialogue ke nomor 34.
Number 34. What will the class do next?
Iya, kira-kira tadi diomongin gurunya itu apa yang mereka lanjutkan sebelumnya, kata Pak gurunya atau profesornya.
Sir, dissect a computer monitor.
Okay, dissect a computer
monitor.
Kalau diartikan apa ini bahasa Indonesianya, Bu?
Ada Wilson.
Ada si cantik ngomong.
Maaf.
Gak apa-apa, lucu aja. Untung anak saya udah tidur. Kok gak laptopnya dibanting. Gimana? Dissect itu namanya dis, tidak sect. Dissect biasanya. Oke. Nah, meskipun kita tidak tahu artinya, coba kita ini. Kalau Bapak Ibu yang lain gimana pilihan jawabannya? Kita
seperti membedah monitor komputer gitu.
Iya, membedah. Mereka membedah, tapi ada tadi, kalau nggak salah tadi ditekankan ada this is entitled gitu, berarti ada judulnya. Kalau ada judulnya Bapak Ibu, mereka di kelas, itu sedang di kelas loh. Kalau ditanya pasti, kalau Bapak Ibu, where does the conversation take place? Di mana kira-kira? Karena di awal tadi ada subject. Before we talk about ini berarti.
If you review the film about the monitor, is it?
Okay, review the film about monitors. Okay. Review the film about monitors. Ada tadi review ya, Bapak Ibu. Nah, kita dengarkan lagi nanti ya. Ada yang Bapak Ibu yang memilih ini, watch another film. Karena disebutkan judulnya berarti film baru dong. Menurut saya seperti itu, Bapak Ibu. Nah, kita dengarkan lagi gimana Bapak Ibu? Karena ini kan
ya,
latihan kan?
Boleh, sir.
Oke. Oke. We want to make sure our answers ya. Kita pastikan dulu apakah benar nggak sih jawaban kami ini. So, I will replay this audio. So, I need you, kita di apa ya, langsung ke itunya ya, ke soalnya ya, karena di awal-awal itu hanya contoh soal. Sebentar Bapak Ibu.
And the man talking is in the man talking. Based on the conversation, on the recording you hear A talk. Based on the moves, Monica will find. Now, begin work on the question.
Okay, kita dengarkan lagi ya Bapak Ibu.
Questions.
Questions 31 through 34. Listen to the conversation between a professor and a student.
There is one more section I'd like to spend a few moments reviewing before we close our books for the day. Who here remembers the film we watched last month on hazardous waste?
You mean the one about computer and television monitors?
Yes, that's the one, Lisa. In the film, they discussed why some states are making it illegal to dump monitors into regular landfills. Can anyone remember the reason? Yes, Lisa?
It's because of the cathode ray tubes, also known as CRTs, inside them. These tubes are high in lead content, and the lead can leak into the groundwater, right?
Excellent. It's nice to know that some of you were listening, even though it wasn't the most upbeat documentary. Now, does anyone remember the reason why manufacturers placed lead in the CRTs of computer and TV monitors in the first place?
The tubes are infused with lead in order to shield the viewer from harmful X-rays. There is no known alternative at this time, but I think the film said that researchers are working on it.
Yes, that's true. And why wasn't this a problem 20 years ago? Why is it suddenly a major concern?
That's simple. It's because nearly every household in the U.S. has a television, and many have three or four. My family is guilty of this, I admit. And not only that, people are throwing out their TVs and computer monitors in order to keep up with the new technology. You know, like the flat-screen LCD monitors. With the digital age upon us, this is going to pose even more of a problem. I have to admit, I got a new plasma TV a few months ago, and there was nothing wrong with my old TV.
Well, I'm sure you're not the only one, Lisa. Now, since you're on a roll, why can't these old monitors just be recycled?
Well, unlike paper and plastics, there just aren't any services that provide this type of recycling. According to the film, a lot of companies that recognize the threat are storing their unused equipment in warehouses until some better solutions become available.
Yes, and this brings us to our next film. Lisa, would you mind dimming the lights? This film is titled Landfill Solutions. It deals with a number of products that can be recycled through innovative means.
Question number 31. What is the topic of the discussion?
Iya, Bapak Ibu, gimana? Menurut Bapak Ibu, sudah setuju kah? Jawabannya A. ladies and gentlemen, gimana? Pak Afif, sudah setuju kah? Betul ya? Pak Afif tadi jawab ini ya. Harusnya ada dua sih, TV and computer. Tapi di sini yang ada hanya computer. Ya, yang ada hanya television. Karena ke tengah-tengahnya sampai akhir mereka hanya ngomongin tentang televisinya. Tapi agak ada persamaan dengan computer sebenarnya. Oke. Nah, ini Bapak Ibu yang terkecoh, mungkin Bapak Ibu tadi dengannya SRT dengan CRT, padahal di sini C ya, cathode, kan C kan, cathode ray tubes ya, kalau disingkat CRT, bukan SRT gitu ya. Oke, jadi the answer is Charlie. Nah, jadi kata si perempuannya tadi kalau ditanya si gurunya, kenapa itu masalah di abad zaman dulu gitu, 20 tahun yang lalu gitu ya. Nah, jawab si Lisa tadi, there aren't ya. Enggak ada yang, dia tidak ada perusahaan yang waktu itu menerima ya atau memberikan layanan untuk mendaur ulang gitu. Oke, Bapak Ibu sudah setujukah jawabannya C, watch another film? Bapak Ibu gimana ini? Apakah pusing atau ngantuk atau gimana?
Kalau saya setuju karena saya yang jawab.
Oke, betul ya. Oke, Bapak Ibu. So, enggak usah terlalu nanti kok ini susah banget dah. Kadang-kadang nih soal TOEFL atau IELTS atau soal bahasa Inggris itu kan listeningnya juga beda-beda. Bisa saja nanti ibu tidak menemukan yang hal-hal yang berbau teknologi. Atau nanti bapak ibu malah mendapatkan yang lebih gampang lagi tentang economics. Ya? Atau orang matematika nanti tiba-tiba dihadapkan dengan dunia sastra yang teksnya gitu. Jadi semua orang itu akan nanti memiliki kesusahannya tersendiri. Nah, inilah kita belajar strateginya. Jadi langsung, ini kan bukan bidang saya, kok topiknya susah banget sih, kadang-kadang ada yang mahasiswa itu sering ngomongin kayak gitu. Ya, apalagi di Fakultas Sastra. Bagaimana Pak kalau misalkan ini, kita kan bukan ahli fisika atau apa? Nah, jadi strategi inilah yang membantu kita, artinya memang vocabulary kita terbatas di bidang-bidang tertentu. Contohnya bidang hukum, karena Bapak Ibu, you are majoring in management or in economics, maybe you are lack of chemistry vocabulary yang di bidang kimia kurang gitu. Tapi coba nanti digunakan strategi yang kita jelaskan tadi ya. Oke, satu soal lagi Bapak Ibu boleh ya? 4 pertanyaan boleh?
Boleh Pak.
Oke, okay. Ya, thank you. Saya akan kok stop sharing. Oke, saya akan putar lagi. Sebentar ya, Bapak Ibu, ini long dialogue. Saya pilih. Oke, Bapak Ibu sebentar ya. Ini file-nya banyak banget. Bapak Ibu, coba diterima file ini dulu ya, seperti yang tadi, ini yang long dialogue A nanti ya, sebentar. TOEFL, preparation, khusus TOEFL. Oke, Bapak Ibu tolong dicek dulu filenya sudah ada kah? Judulnya Long Dialogue A. Bapak Ibu sudah?
Not so.
Not yet. Okay. Sebentar.
I'm done.
Okay. Some of you have downloaded it. Yang lain nanti dipastikan sudah, kalau sudah semuanya biar kita putar.
Sudah.
Dan sir.
Oke, okay. Now we are going to play this audio. Let me share it first. Share with sound. Ya. Kadang-kadang saya lupa. Okay, let me get a long dialogue.
Part B. In this part of the test, you will hear longer conversations. After each conversation, you will hear several questions. The conversation and the questions will not be repeated. After you hear a question, read the four possible answers in your test book and choose the best answer. Then, on your answer sheet, find the number of the question and fill in the space that corresponds to the letter of the answer that you have chosen. Here's an example. On the recording you hear,
questions 31 through 32. Listen to the conversation between two people.
Is Monica there, please?
I'm sorry. She isn't here right now. Can I give her a message?
Yes, this is George. Please ask her to call me at work.
Okay. Can you give me your phone number, please?
Sure. It's 555-2891. On the recording, you hear, where are the woman and the man talking? In your test book, you read, A. In the office. B. On the phone. C. At Monica's house. D. At school. Based on the conversation, the suitable answer for the question, where are the women and the man talking, is on the phone. Therefore, the best choice is B. On the recording, you hear, what is the meaning of the word call? In your test book, you read, A. Phone. B. Mention. C. Screen. D. Talk. Based on the man's statement, please ask her to call me at work. It can be known that he hopes Monica will phone him. Therefore, the correct choice is A. Phone. Now, begin work on the questions. Questions 31 through 34. Listen to the conversation between two people who are describing their neighborhoods.
Where do you live?
I live in an apartment downtown.
Oh, that's convenient. But how much crime is there?
Not much, but there's a lot of traffic. I can't stand the noise sometimes. Where do you live?
I have a house in the suburbs.
Oh, I bet it's really quiet. But is there much to do there?
No, not much. In fact, nothing ever really happens. That's the trouble.
Hey, let's trade places one weekend.
Okay, great idea.
Question number 31. What is the topic of the talk?
Okay, Bapak Ibu, sebentar saya. Mana nih? Okay. What's the topic of the talk, Bapak Ibu? Topiknya apa? describing two different neighbors, things to do downtown, how to own a house in the suburbs, the trouble with living in the suburbs.
D.
Delta?
Mana tuh? Yes.
Oke. Okay. Pak Edjanto chooses A. Delta ya? Delta. Yang lain, Bapak Ibu? Delta berarti masalah tinggal di suburbs ya. Suburbs itu seperti bolehlah kita bilang pedesaan ya. Okay, describe two different neighbors, trouble with living in the suburbs. To own a house in the suburbs. Okay. Selain PD Janto, the others, Bapak Ibu?
It's different with apartment and suburb.
Okay. Pak Andreas chooses yang mana nih? Ini saya perlihatkan.
A.
Alpha. Okay, describing two different neighbors. Okay, ada yang lain Bapak Ibu? So, antara Delta and Alpha ya? Okay. Ya, kalau disuruh memilih Bapak Ibu. Okay, kita kunci jawaban A dan D. Ya, yang mana yang Bapak Ibu?
Alpha.
Lebih Alpha. Yes, that's the correct answer. Karena kenapa tidak D, bukan hanya tadi menerangkan tentang trouble, padahal si laki-lakinya malah suka loh di tinggal di suburbs katanya. Dia nggak suka di downtown karena berisik katanya. Berarti kita menyimpulkan berarti ngomongin ya artinya antara suburbs and downtown, berarti neighborhoods ya gitu ya. Atau kalau kita melihat ada dua hal seperti ini berarti ada dua antara dua hal ya. Ya, the different ya. Oke. Okay. Kita ke nomor 32. Kita baca di sini in capital city of his state, downtown, the suburbs berarti tempat yang akan ditanya. Benar enggak sih? Gitu ya.
2. Where does the man live?
Iya, yang ditanya si laki-lakinya, Bapak Ibu. Where's the man live?
B.
Downtown.
Downtown.
Iya, karena dia bilang tadi, I live in apartment downtown. Ya. Iya, jelas tadi ya. Berarti Bapak Ibu sudah... ini tadi jelas ya dengarnya ya. I live in apartment downtown. Okay. Downtown. Soalnya itu seperti Depok, Bekasi, itu di luar samping-samping kota lah dia ya. Oke, Bapak Ibu, kita ke pertanyaan 33.
And how is living? According to the number 33. According to the man, how is living in the apartment downtown?
Iya, Bapak Ibu. Menurut si laki-laki itu gimana sih tinggal di apartemen di luar kita sebut luar kota lah ya, seperti Bekasi, Depok, Tangerang. Gimana sih tinggal di apartemen downtown, Bapak Ibu rasanya?
Si.
Pak Afif.
Noise.
Noise.
Oke, okay. Pak Afif noisy. Ya, noisy. It's noisy. Berisik, ya. Bapak Ibu, ada pilihan jawaban lain? Yes, ya, yeah, most of you, saya yakin Bapak Ibu dia tadi dengar ada kata noise-nya, ya. Kebisingannya, ya. Bising, oke. Okay. Oke, okay, Bapak Ibu, yang ditanyakan berarti nanti jumlahnya, ya. Karena di sini ada 1, 2, 3, and 4. Benar nggak sih pertanyaannya itu how many?
Number 34. How many houses does the woman have?
Iya, Bapak Ibu. How many houses does the woman have? 1, 2, 3, or 4? Four?
Yes.
Okay. Ini Pak apa? Pak
Tombek.
Pak Gad?
No, oh, Pak Tombek.
Pak Tombek. Ya. Okay. Pak Tombek jawabannya A. Eh, D ya, four ya. Bapak Ibu yang lain? Oke, okay, Pak Combe bilangnya jawabannya di Delta 4. Ada 4 rumah katanya dia miliki. Bapak Ibu yang lain? Kumaha? Jawabannya?
Emang Dainang.
Gimana? Enak banget belajar bahasa ini ya. Gimana Bapak Ibu? Okay.
I'm not perfect listening, Miss. Mister,
I know that's why we practice, right? Makanya sebenarnya Bapak Ibu, nanti audionya ini Bapak Ibu mau saya berikankah untuk dijadikan latihan di handphonenya, mungkin bisa nanti diunggah.
Yes, sir.
Oke, okay. Yeah. Berarti most of you need the file. Okay, I'll send the file. Nah, kita selesaikan dulu nih Bapak Ibu. Oke, setelah kita jawab, pilihan saya adalah one karena dia e tadi, a house, ya. Oke, kita review langsung ke percakapan yang tadi ya, Bapak Ibu Chom.
Yes, this is George. Please answer. Where are the rooms? B. D. For the question. Therefore, the you here your test book, you B. Screen. Please ask her to call. Monica will phone him. Questions. Questions 31 through 34. Listen to the conversation between two people who are describing their neighborhoods.
Where do you live?
I live in an apartment downtown.
Oh, that's convenient. But how much crime is there?
Not much, but there's a lot of traffic. I can't stand the noise sometimes. Where do you live?
I have a house in the suburbs.
Oh, I bet it's really quiet. But is there much to do there?
No, not much. In fact, nothing ever really happens. That's the trouble.
Hey, let's trade places one weekend.
Okay, great idea.
Question number 31. What is the topic of the talk?
Iya, Bapak Ibu sudah ya? Sudah sepakat jawabannya A ya? Topiknya itu ya Bapak Ibu, betul?
Yes, sir.
Iya, untuk memastikan lagi sebelum tadi pembicaraan juga naratornya bilang tentang neighborhood ya. Berarti sudah pasti itu. Oke, 32 berarti benar ya tadi ya. I live in apartment downtown ya. Nah, tadi that's a lot traffic dan juga dia mendengarkan suara berisik ya, berarti noisy. Nah, nomor 4 kita pastikan tadi I live in a house gitu ya.
Screen. Coba. Monica will phone him.
Where do you live?
I live in an apartment downtown.
Oh, that's convenient. But how much crime is there?
Not much, but there's a lot of traffic. I can't stand the noise sometimes. Where do you live?
I have a house in the suburbs.
Iya, Bapak Ibu. Sudah ya? I have a house in the suburbs. Berarti sudah sepakat ya Bapak Ibu?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, Bapak Ibu, sebelum kita tutup, before we close, I want to take a screenshot. Can you open the camera for a while? Yang bisa dibuka kameranya sebentar Bapak Ibu, saya pengen kenal wajah Bapak Ibu. Thank you, Pak Edi. Hi, how are you, Pak Edi? It's nice to see you. Hi, Pak Afif. How are you? It's great to see you too. Hi, Pak Anton. Wow. Bapak Ibu, saya baru mengenal wajahnya minggu lalu. Kita terburu-buru ya, karena ini. Oke, saya pakai gallery aja lah. Hai Pak Gad. Hai Miss Anissa. Pak Tombek. He's in the car now. Hi to Patomik, is in the car. He's in the way go home maybe. Bapak Ibu, saya ambil screenshot ya biar saya ada dokumentasi sambil saya bisa mengenang kebersamaan kita di kursus ini. Okay, I'll send also to our WhatsApp crew. Maybe saya suka mengumpulkan memori melalui foto. Bapak Ibu, ada ini sebelum kita tutup, ada permintaan sesuatu atau ada yang mau kasih pendapat, gimana? I'm open, I'm an open-minded person. If you suggest something, maybe. Kalau Bapak Ibu punya contoh soal, mungkin kita bahas itu atau gimana? Tetap dari saya.
Very very good lah.
Okay, I'm very glad to hear that. I do appreciate it. Thank you. I take that as a compliment. Yeah. Thank you, Bapak Ibu. I'll see you next week. I'll send the file, the MP3 file, via our WhatsApp group. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir. Good night.
My pleasure. Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, Sir Gunawan.
Oh iya, Miss Tina yang nutup ya.
It's okay, never mind.
Okay. Makasih ya Miss Tina ya.
Iya, sama-sama Pak. Terima kasih banyak di kelas malam ini. Baik, Bapak Ibu sekalian, terima kasih untuk kehadirannya di kelas yang lumayan panjang hari ini, kalau hari Senin ya Bapak Ibu ya. Karena ada dua kelas kebetulan langsung berurutan. Okay, baik kalau begitu.
Yeah, Miss.
Iya, untuk mungkin Pak Tombek yang masih sedang di jalan, hati-hati di jalan Pak, semoga bisa sampai di rumah dengan selamat. Dan untuk Bapak dan Ibu lainnya, selamat istirahat, selamat malam, sampai berjumpa di hari Jumat besok.
Okay, thank you, Miss.
Terima kasih, Miss.
Thank you. Terima kasih, Mbak Gunawan.
Selamat malam.
Selamat malam semuanya.
Bye-bye.
Ya, silakan. Bye.